the impact felt like I'd been clubbed over the head with a baseball bat.
I think it is paramount that player safety is put first.
We have a duty of care to look after players' short-term immediate safety, but also long-term, the impacts of potential head injuries for their later career and retirement. Together with Loughborough, we're trying to better understand what a lifetime in cricket might mean, and also what the individual components of those might mean, and how we make helmets and make the game safer.
It hit me extremely hard. That's certainly the hardest I've ever been hit, and my first experience of concussion, definitely.
What we're recognising now is that when you have a concussion, you have to treat it like an injury. So you actually need to rest, and you need to come back at the right time. You need to take a graded return to your cricket afterwards, because actually, in the first instance after you're hit, and you might feel a bit dazed, you might recover quite quickly, but actually it just takes time for your brain to settle down.
Well, they're going to go for two. This should be close. It should be out.
Hit the keeper right.
You know, your health comes first and foremost, so that's paramount. And if no one wants to miss games of cricket, especially for injuries. It's a very frustrating part of professional sport, but concussion is such a serious issue, and it's not to be taken lightly.
There's so much about head injury that we don't understand. I mean, clearly our knowledge today is far, far greater than it was even 10 years ago. But there's still an awful lot that we don't know. So the implications of where you are hit, does it make a difference whether you're hit on the temple or on the side of the head? Does that lead to different symptoms within a player? Does it mean that we should be protecting different parts of the head differently? These are all questions that we are doing our very best to try and answer. So the partnership between the ECB and the university that's really been driven by Nick Pearce has been to help him to understand the risks that his players are taking when they take the field of play, and how he can better prevent injury and treat injury when it happens. So the abilities that we have in our lab to look at the physical collisions that occur in cricket represents a really good, strong partnership that we can feed off each other's knowledge and hopefully benefit cricket in the long term. In the case of cricket, we have a 156 gram ball, maybe travelling at 80 miles an hour, and the contact with the head can be as small as 3 milliseconds. So in that tiny time, the ball is going from full speed towards you to a reduced speed away from you. That means that the forces can be very localised, very sharp, but extremely high for a very short period of time. Compare that to a sport like boxing or rugby, where yes, you also see very high forces, maybe even higher forces, but they extend over longer periods. And it's those sorts of questions that we're trying to answer in our labs.
We're starting to see different patterns of helmet strikes. So we record about 100 helmet strikes, 80 to 100 a year. There's probably about 150 occur in the first class game. And we're starting to categorize those into the frontal head strikes that cause a lot of energy transfer, side on that bounce off at 90 degrees and still create some degree of energy transfer, and those that are glancing blows. And we're starting to monitor what happens to players after that, both in terms of performance, in terms of, health measures. And we're interested to know how to improve the helmet's function in those instances.
This was nasty, it was quick, and he took his eyes off it.
Every helmet strike in the game is recorded. That goes on to a central database. We're alerted to that helmet strike. We take in details related to that helmet strike in terms of the time of the game, the age of the ball, the speed of the bowler, and then we monitor the impact of that helmet strike in terms of the health of the player. And then We can take that data, we can give it to Sports Technology Institute to Loughborough University, they can analyse that, and it's part of our long-term project to understand the forces involved and what may happen to players afterwards.
The ability that we might now have is to extract the specific details of any particular incident. And the control that we have with our equipment in the lab means that we have the ability to replicate a very specific event, the speed, the direction, the condition of the ball, the location of impact on the head. And we have the ability to repeat that as many times as we need to truly get an understanding of what might have happened to that particular player. And then see if we can tie it in with the results of the medical diagnosis and the rehabilitation of the player so that we can improve that cycle in the future.
So every player in the game has a winter baseline. So we're looking at understanding what players' normal is like and then what changes after helmet strikes. So in the long term, if a player's in the game for 10 years, we've got records every year of how their cognitive function, their health changes, and we can relate that to the number of helmet strikes, the injuries they may or may not have had.
Once you have been checked out and you've been given the all clear, knowing the how thorough the testing is, and it gives you a bit more confidence actually that actually you are really fine to go out and you can just carry on.
The players buy into it, they understand now concussion's important, they want the game to be safer, they're looking to play the game more aggressively, they're taking more risks, you know, they're not thinking about necessarily whether they're hitting the helmet or not. So we need the helmets to do their job.
It gives you confidence as a player knowing that all that work's going on behind the scenes. You're wearing good, solid equipment which looks after you and keeps you safe on the field. You know, and I'm sure that over the next couple of years they'll only improve and only get better. And you know, that can only be a good thing for the sport.